welcome back to my channel. Today I'm doing skincare routine video for you guys. This video was requested by one of my subscribers, and you know who you are. I want to tell you guys this, to do this disclaimer. Some of these products may work for me, but they may not work for you. Everyone has different type of skin. My skin is oily and acne prone. I also have large pores, and I've been struggling with acne since when I was 13, and so it's been a constant struggle for me to find the right products for my skin. At this point, I've just kind of came to terms with the fact that I'm probably going to always have acne, mainly because over the last 6, 7, 8 months, I've been trying a lot of products, and I'll see a difference in my skin, in my acne, for a short amount of time, and then it just basically just goes back to the way it was. Not completely back to the way it was, but I still struggle with acne. As you can see, I have some that are healing up here, and then I have some here, and then I have one that just came up yesterday right here, and then I had this one's healing up, but I also have some hyperpigmentation from old acne and some redness. Of course, that's just the way my skin is. But I come to terms with it, and I'm really just trying to find the products that don't break me out, and also products that will make my skin smooth and soft and moisturized and not too oily, mainly for my makeup application. I figure, you know, if I'm going to struggle with acne and my skin's not going to be amazing all the time, I just figure just work towards my skin looking amazing when I put my makeup on. So I recently got new skincare that I bought from Ulta, which will be in the next video in my Ulta haul. And I didn't want to mention those in my video because I feel like I've only had them one day, so it's kind of misleading for me to even mention them in my skincare routine, because they're not really in my routine yet. So the ones I'm going to mention, I have been using for a while, and a while meaning like at least 2 weeks for the shortest ones, and at least a few months for the longest ones. So I don't have any makeup on today because I wanted you to see the true nature of my skin, and that yes, it is not flawless. And that's just the way my life is with my skin. So anyway, I want to start off with my cleansers, what I use. I like to shake it up a little bit with the cleansers, because I feel that sometimes when I use a cleanser for a long period of time, it starts to like stop working properly or the way I want it to work. So I shake it up with my cleansers, and I really like doing it that way. First of all, I want to mention the massager that I use to massage the cleanser into my face. It's this right here. It is Hallicare or something like that. I bought this off of Amazon, and of course it's blue because I love blue. I bought this off of Amazon for $20. Actually, it was like $19.95 or something like that. Kathleen Lights had did a video of comparing this to the Foreo that you can get from Ulta, or I know you can get it from Ulta. But anyway, and she had said that it was close to being a dupe. There was a couple of differences. But honestly, I am not the type of person to go out and purchase, you know, $100 or so worth of something that I'm going to use just, you know, to basically massage my face. And I bought this because I wanted to see if I would like it, because I feel like sometimes when I wash my face, the cleanser isn't really like getting deep down in there. And, you know, like I, with my skin, I feel like I constantly need something to exfoliate it to get it nice and smooth. Otherwise I get built up dead skin right here on my forehead, and when I put my foundation on, that will pick it up. But with this, it's like it makes my skin so smooth, and it makes it feel like that it's getting the cleanser down into my pores and really, really getting my skin clean. So for $20, you really can't beat this, and it's wonderful. It comes with a little charger you connect it to your laptop or your computer or whatever, or if you have a USB charger that plugs in the wall, it just plugs in right back here, and it'll blink when you click on here. You can turn it up or down. I just click on it and it just leave it at the regular setting. But I just, when you click on here, we press this, it'll start blinking if it needs to be charged. So anyway, I really love this, and I feel like it is definitely worth the buy. If you are the type of person that really wants to feel that clean, this is your go-to. And I'll have the link in the description box below. So if anyone of you are like me, don't want to spend hundreds of dollars on something like this, go try this out, definitely. So the three cleansers that I've been using, I've kind of been shaking it up a little bit. Like I said, I like to try do different cleansers just because. So the first one I want to mention, because I'm sure everybody has seen a YouTuber mention this cleanser, but it's the Cetaphil Gentle Skin Cleanser. I do like this. I've used it for several months now, and it's really, really good. The only thing I have to complain about is I feel like it doesn't get me clean enough. I do have very oily skin, and so this is very gentle, very good. I would recommend this more for dry skin types, because it does not strip your skin of its oils. And I do like it. I do feel like it does get clean, but not as clean as I want my skin to feel, especially the fact that I have a very acne prone, and you know, I want to make sure my skin is clean, you know what I'm saying? So anyway, this is really good. I probably use this probably about once a month now, or maybe a couple times a month. I don't really reach for this very often. But anyway, my next cleanser I go for often because I feel like it gives me a really good clean, and it is the it is from Lush, and it is the Kohl Face Cleanser. As you can see, I'm like almost gone. It's almost gone, so I'm gonna have to order this soon again. But that's another reason why I like to switch up my my cleansers, is because I want my cleansers to last. You know what I mean? Because those are the ones that you use more often. Like, you know, you have your daytime creams, and then you have your nighttime creams. So you only use them technically once a day. But with your cleanser, you're using them twice a day, or however much you wash your face during the day. So I feel like, you know, also switching it up helps the product last a lot longer. So I use this. Also use this to cleanse, and I do feel like it gets my skin nice and clean, and it just I feel like it also helps like calm down my acne just a little bit. I mean, not significantly, but it does help. So that's why I've been continuing to use it. When I first started out my channel, this was the first thing, one of the first videos I did on this. And at first I was like, I absolutely loved it. It was like, oh my god, I love it. It's amazing. And then I kind of was like, oh, well, it's kind of not really doing its job anymore. So that's when I realized, I was like, I need to shake up my cleansers a little bit. So anyway, the next one I had bought probably like a month or so ago, it is the Hey Honey Don't Miss a Spot Propolis Cleansing Foam. I had did some research on propolis and found that it was supposed to help with acne and basically oil controlling and everything like that. And I do really like this, but I find it is really expensive, honestly, overpriced. I do like it to clean. It does get my skin nice and clean, But I don't really notice a significant difference in my acne. And that's kind of disappointing because when I get done with this, I'm probably not going to repurchase it. And I find that there are other cleansers out there that could do the same thing without being so freaking expensive. But this is nice, and I do use it, and I like it. And it, you know, it does help a little. So, another cleanser that I don't use very often, but I do use it because I feel that it does help when I use it, is the Lush Herbalism. And I actually went into the store and bought this. The store was actually about like an hour and a half to 2 hours from me, and I really wanted to go in store because there wasn't one near me. So I ended up picking this up because I wanted to try it. The only complaint that I have is that it's so annoying to get on my face and scrub around because there's like these little scrubby things. It's ground almonds and something else in there. Ground almonds, like an exfoliating. And I feel like it's too chunky and it kind of just really like crumbles off my face when I put it on. And I've tried mixing it with, you know, less water or more water, and it's still the same either way. But I feel like it does get my skin nice and clean, and it does make it feel nice and smooth and exfoliating. So, and I feel like exfoliating your skin is very important. So I really do like this, and I don't have very much left. I don't know if you can see in there, but it is really, I do like it. I do like it. I'm not sure if I'll repurchase it or not. We shall see. We shall see. After I cleanse, I do, and I know this is going to sound weird because when you clean your face, you're like, okay, everything's off my face, the dirt, oil, everything's out of my pores, and I feel confident that my skin is clean. But for me, when I clean my face, I, you know, after I get done washing my face, I pat my face dry with a towel, like I pat very lightly. And then when I'm done doing that, I feel like I just patted whatever's on that towel into my skin. And that includes like the fabric softener that I use. And some people have really sensitive skin towards fabric softener. So I feel like if I just take this extra step, it might make a difference. And when I started doing it, it did make a little bit of a difference in my skin. And so I go with this. This is the Garnier Skin Active Micellar Cleansing Water. I initially bought this because you can see I barely have any left. I initially bought this because I wanted to use it to remove makeup, and that's it. But I noticed that when I removed my makeup with this, and then I went in with, you know, cleansing my face, like I used this to remove my makeup, then I cleansed my face, and then, you know, continued the rest of my routine. But I noticed when I used this, I felt like my skin was a lot more calm, and it felt cleaner. So, I just, out of a whim, a thought, I was like, you know what, after I'm going to cleanse, I'm going to, you know, take a cotton pad and just, you know, wipe it all over my skin just to get it that extra clean. And when I did that, I felt like there was a difference in how clean my skin felt and also with helping my acne heal faster. So I love this stuff. I'm going to have to get more, obviously. I might try a different brand of the micellar water because, I mean, I do like this, but there are so many out on the market right now that I feel like, what if there's one out there that could do even better of a job than this? So, that is that. And then after that, I do go in with a toner. I was using my tea tree toner from Lush, but I felt like it wasn't really making that much of a big difference to my skin. So I was like, okay, let me see what else toners that are out there. And so I was researching, and I watched some YouTube videos, and a lot of YouTubers were raving about this one product that I'm about to talk about. And I did a lot more research, and I did read some reviews on people who had acne who said that it made a significant difference in their acne. And that is the Pixi Glow Tonic. I originally went to Target and I bought this little bottle, which was $15. And I wasn't really happy about the price, but once I started using it, I was noticing a huge difference in my skin. Like, my skin was so smooth, so soft, and not only that, now that I've been using it for about almost a month now, I feel like it helps my acne heal faster. Like, before I had gotten this, I noticed that whenever I would get a breakout, my breakouts would stay there with me for a couple of week to a couple of weeks, and it would still be there, you know what I mean? Like, still flaming and just annoying. But when I started using this, I noticed that my acne will heal up faster, and also improves my skin, the smoothness, the texture, everything has just been so amazing with this. And I swear this would be great for all skin tones. And I absolutely love this. This has 5% glycolic acid, aloe vera, and ginseng. And I feel like it is so amazing. I actually had to order a larger one because it's just, I'm not going to be without this because I feel like it has made such a big difference in my skin. I mean, I know that my skin does not look amazing now to most people, but to be perfectly honest with you, my skin was worse than this. This was way worse. I mean, I was always having acne all on my neck and my chin. And then there will be times where I will get acne here. And then, you know, like on my brows, like right here, or, but mainly right here on my chin and my neck area. And I think it has a lot to do with my, you know, I don't eat very healthy, and yeah, there's just a couple of factors that have to do with that. But to be perfectly honest with you, I have tried eating more healthy, and I kind of just drop off, and I try to do my best. Honestly, I take my vitamins every day, and I, you know, whatever, but it's so difficult for me, because I love food and I love junk food. So anyway, this stuff, if you are looking for a toner, I will not steer you wrong. This stuff is amazing. And everybody else who uses it and who swears by it, they do not lie, because I love this stuff. Okay, anyway, so how I apply this is with just the cotton pad. And I just put like a few drops in there on the cotton pad. Make sure it feels like my skin is actually getting wet. And then I start down here where my issues are. And where the most product is going to be applied, and then I do the rest of my face. And then I will spot treat my acne. I never used to do that before because I felt like it was kind of like useless, you know, just put a cream on that'll treat your acne and prevent other acne. But I don't have so much acne on my face. I feel like, you know, there's just the problem areas down here. That I could just use a treatment to spot treat. And lately I have been using this Grease Lightening from Lush. And I do like it, and I feel like it does help heal my acne a little bit faster. But I did actually order another spot treatment, which I'll be doing another video for my Ulta haul, which is where I got it. Anyway, this is a big bottle. You know, so you use very, very small amount, and I definitely think that it helps. And, you know, if my other spot treatment fails, I'll go back to this because it does work. It just, I like to try new things, and if I can find something that's better than this, then, you know, why not? But anyway, so I go in with that, and I let it sink into my skin, before I go in with my next step, which is a serum. So the serum that I've been using for a while now, this is actually like almost gone. It's the Vitamin C Serum by Rada Beauty. I actually bought this off of Amazon, and when I first started using it, I felt like it was making a huge difference in my skin. But then after a while, I felt like it wasn't really doing anything at all. So I'm not going to be repurchasing this, so I actually bought another serum, which is obviously going to be in the next video, but, I don't know, I feel like it does do something for me, but it's not significant to the point where I just want to go out and buy it again, you know what I'm saying? So I was like, you know what, let's just try something else. So that's that. When I'm doing the nighttime, I used to do this morning and night, but, now that I don't really like, it's not really doing that much for me. I do this at night, the Pixi Overnight Glow Serum. This one has a higher concentration of glycolic acid. It doesn't say how much the percentage. But this, I think, is so good with this. And they basically do the same thing, except this is a lower percentage and this is higher percentage. It makes my skin feel so smooth and so soft, and I feel like this also helps with my acne to heal up faster. The only complaint that I have with this is, when I was using it during the day, my skin got oilier than usual during the day, after probably about like a few hours after I used this. I mean, at night, that's fine to have oily at night. It's not that big of a deal. I would wake up like super oily, which is not that big of a deal because I'm going to be washing my face anyway. And the extra oil does not make me break out. So yeah, I absolutely love this stuff. This will be a staple for my overnight. I love it. It's amazing. And then next, I will go in with an eye cream, and I was using this one here, the Rada Beauty eye gel, and it feels nice and cooling on the eyes, and it feels good, but it moisturizes under the eyes as well, which is great, but I didn't really notice a huge difference, because it's supposed to be, you know, for like wrinkles and stuff like that. And I just ran out of it, so I'm not going to be repurchasing this because I feel like I can try other stuff and get better results. So this is what I would usually use for the, you know, time being until I was able to get a different something to try out. So, it was all right. It wasn't like, I'm not going to sit here and rave about it because it wasn't that significant to me. And then after my eyes, I let that soak into my eyes because I don't want to like push any, like move it around on the rest of my face. So I let it soak in. And then I go in with a moisturizer. I know it seems kind of like overkill, for someone with oily skin, but when you moisturize your skin, it really helps with, your makeup application. If you're not moisturizing, then your makeup is gonna look like shit. Let's just put it that way. I mean, that's my God's honest opinion. I don't mean to be rude or mean, but that's just the way it is. Oily skin, even when I, you know, the fact that I'm oily, even when I didn't moisturize, there would be like dry spots anyway, even though I was oily. So I was like, what the fuck? Like, I don't get it. Like, I'm so oily, but I got dry spots. So, I mean, even in my oily, really oily spots, I had some, like, little bit of, I don't know, it was crazy. My skin's crazy. So moisturizer is the key to good foundation. Good flawless looking foundation. Anyway, I was using this. This is by Rada Beauty Miracle Retinol Moisturizer. And I loved this stuff, like, I lived for this. This felt so good going on my skin, and it moisturized my skin well without making it over oily. It didn't leave a residue, and I really, really genuinely like this, but I feel like it didn't make so much of a difference for what it's advertised for. When I ran out actually like a couple weeks ago. And I was like, okay, man, I'm freaking out now because what if this is making my skin look amazing and once I stop it, it's going to be fucked up again. But no, once I stopped this, it didn't really make that huge of a difference. And so I was like, you know what? This is retarded because if I run out of something and it's not making that much of a difference to my skin, I'm not going to repurchase it. Fuck that. Sorry. I'm just like, I'm getting revved up because I love skincare. But anyway, so this was good, but it was not something, this is not something I'm going to repurchase. After I did run out of that, I did go out and I was like, I still need a moisturizer. So I did go out and went to Ulta and I did a little bit of research online and everything. And I decided to pick this up, which is the First Aid Beauty, Ultra Repair Face Moisturizer. They do have a heavier cream than this. But I wanted something a little bit lighter, and I didn't want a little little cup or jar, whatever you want to call it. I wanted a pump, you know, and so when I started using this, I was like, oh yeah, this feels good. Like, it soaks right into the skin. There's no oily residue, no nothing. It just feels amazing. It doesn't freak me out. I freaking love this stuff. But the only complaint I do have is that when I use during the day, it does kind of like get me a little oily, which I'm oily as it is. So it's kind of like counterproductive, especially when I want to wear makeup. That day, I feel like my makeup gets a little bit more oily than normal. So I figured I would just use this for my nighttime routine. And, you know, I do actually, I bought a daytime cream, which I have on today. Yeah, so, but yeah, I do really like this stuff. It doesn't break me out. It's great. I love it. Now, every couple times a week, I will do a mask, and I used to do, I used to have my little sheet masks that I got from Walmart. They're like $2.50 a piece. The propolis sheet mask. I love that one. It makes my skin feel freaking amazing. I need to go out and get some more. And I love doing masks because I really feel like they make a significant difference in the way your skin feels and the texture and everything. And so masks, back to masks, they are important to me. And, right now I don't have have very many masks to show you because I've been slacking. But the first one I want to show you, was basically advertised as a mask for people with troubled skin, aka acne prone. And this is the Lush Mask of Magna Minty. And I really do like it. I don't, see, I, you know, I only have a little bit in here, but I love the smell of it. It smells so freaking good. And it feels good on my skin. Basically, I just, you know, rub it all because it does have exfoliating little something in there. Scrubby Aduki beans. So I scrub this on my face and then leave it on, and then I scrub it back off. So I feel like it's like two in one, like it's a mask and it's an exfoliator. So I do like this, and I use this at least once a week. Sometimes, you know, I'll shake it up. If I have more masks, I'll shake it up and do something else besides this, mainly to make it last longer because I do like it. And then the other mask that I have, is something that I bought off of, Vitacost, which is where I get my vitamins from. And this was really cheap, and I thought it was something, you know, worth trying because it was cheap, and it was like, psh, why not, you know? And there was good rave reviews on it. Is the Moroccan, red clay powder, 100% pure, and it's a facial detox / sensitive skin types. And I feel like I do get, like, my face is, like, it does, like, help. But I don't think it's so significant that I would actually go out and buy it again. It's in powder form. You just mix it with water or, you know, whatever. But it does make me feel like I'm, you know, something's happening on my skin. So, but yeah, there's a lot in here, so this will last me so freaking long. So I don't know. I mean, I'll let you guys know how I feel about this, you know, after I run out. So I will be doing a video of, my empties and what I felt about them, whether to repurchase them or whether I'm going to repurchase them or not. So those are the two masks that I have. And next, when I do my skincare, I like to exfoliate my lips at least once a day. When they seem to be overly dry, I do it twice a day. But the lip scrubs that I like, to use, when I started out with this one, my Lush Sugar Plum Fairy one, and I absolutely love this. Like, it tastes amazing. Like, I could sit here and just, you know what I'm saying? It's just, oh, it tastes so good. But I know that's not the purpose of this stuff. So I did not pay out the ass for something, a little tiny dollop of, you know, product that I should be using on my lips and not eating. But anyway, I feel like this does scrub off the dead skin, the dead dry skin. It doesn't moisturize, to be perfectly honest with you. I mean, my lips do feel smooth after I use it, but I really, really have to go in with a lip balm or some type of lip treatment afterwards so that my lips will be moisturized. But this, I do love this, and when I run out, I will be repurchasing this and probably another flavor just because. But I absolutely love Lush. Yes, I do. Anyway, and then the other one I got in my BoxyCharm, which was like, oh my god, yeah, I want that. Like, I'll use the shit out of that. So, is the Beauty For Real lip scrub. I showed you guys in my December BoxyCharm if you want to check that out. Yeah. anyway, this is moisturizing. Like, when I use this, oh, and it smells so good. It's got this the cinnamon bark in it and everything like that. It is great. I love it. I mean, the scrubbies aren't as big as the Lush lip scrub, but it is really, really good, and it does get my lips so smooth, and it does moisturize, but I still go in with a lip treatment or a lip balm. Mainly a lip balm, because I just recently got a lip treatment, actually in my Ipsy bag, to be honest. But my regular lip balm that I really, really like to use is this one by EOS, and I think it's the blueberry one. I'm not sure. But you could probably tell that it's been used quite a bit, and I use it all the time. You know, when I don't have my makeup on, this is what I love it. When I don't have my makeup on, like today, I'll put this on throughout the day to keep my lips nice and moisturized. I don't know where I was going with that. But anyway, so I do love this, and I feel like it does, you know, keep my lips nice and soft and moisturized, and I hate dry lips. Dry hands and dry lips are like, oh, they like give, I it's just a pet peeve of mine. If my hands feel dirty or dry, I have to wash them and moisturize them, or if my lips feel dry, I have to moisturize them. They have to stay moisturized. It's just an obsession of mine. But anyway, when I got my December Ipsy bag, they gave me this Hanalei lip treatment, whatever, and it tastes good, it smells good. And that's what I'm wearing now, and it keeps my lips moisturized and soft and smooth, and I just freaking love it. So actually, after this is gone, I might actually repurchase, because I am liking it so much. Actually, more so than this, because I feel like this This keeps my lips moisturized longer than this does. And on days, and especially during the winter, we all struggle with dry lips and dry skin in general. So that is all I have to share with you guys today. I was actually talking to my fiance yesterday, and I told him, I said, would you let me do your makeup if I reach 1,000 subscribers? And he said, surprisingly, yes. So you need to subscribe so you can watch my fiance get makeup put on. And I'm going to make him look flawless. He said he was even going to shave for me. So that includes, like, you know, all out primer, foundation, powder, like, the works. I want to make him look like a woman, okay? Well, as best as I can. Also, I want to mention, when I hit 50 subscribers, I will be doing a giveaway. I don't want you guys to forget that. So please subscribe if you like my videos and you want to keep seeing what I gotta dish out. When I reach 100 subscribers, I was thinking of having my fiance do my makeup for me, or him doing a voiceover. What do you guys think? Let me know in the comments below. And I guess this wraps up this video. Hit the thumbs up if you like this video, and please subscribe, because I would love to have more subscribers, and we're gonna have some fun. So yeah, it was nice seeing you guys. Bye.